Barging through defensive lines, smashing into rucks and mauls. Anyone who has watched Wallabies and Moana Pasifika rugby star Sekope Kepu knows he's tough. But this morning on Q&A, you are about to see toughness of a different kind. Sekope Kepu is speaking out about bullying and abuse he suffered at one of New Zealand's oldest schools. He spoke exclusively to Indira Stewart.
Wesley College is New Zealand's oldest registered school, made famous in the 90s when late rugby legend and former student Jonah Lomel put it on the map. Three quarters of students are Pasifika, and the school has a history of shaping sports stars, Pacific prime ministers, and two sovereign leaders. A proud history of the 180-year-old school, but one that's been clouded in allegations of abuse and secrets for decades.
These buildings.
On a tour of the school, we see anti-bullying posters plastered on the walls. Former student and rugby star Sekope Kepu is front and centre of the campaign. 20 years after being a student here, he remains staunchly loyal to the Wesley Brotherhood, but he's breaking a code of silence.
I love the school so much, and so do the students that attended Wesley, but I do not condone any of that. You know, the abuse, the military style, you know, the brutal beatings.
Sekope is among dozens of survivors who have spoken up about abuse at the school. The school admits it's likely there are hundreds more victims.
The whole truth and nothing but the truth.
I do.
Those who registered with the National Royal Commission of Inquiry came forward with allegations of abuse between the 1960s up to as recently as last year.
When the Royal Commission approached me, again, I didn't realise how massive it was. And as it got closer and as it, I read the statements from the survivors, to actually hear and see what they were going through and the hurt, the trauma, the experiences, it's just sad that it happened to them and myself included.
The stories predominantly detail physical, psychological and emotional abuse, with some incidences of sexual harassment and sexual abuse. Most incidents involved senior students against junior students. Some staff abused students too.
My parents didn't really know about this whole ordeal that I was going through at Wesley, so...
Until you recently spoke?
Recently, yeah. Wow. Until the Royal Commission came about. It wasn't until a phone call the night before that I actually spoke to my mum about it, and she was livid, as I mentioned, in the Royal Commission. Just upset and disappointed that she didn't know at the time. And she said that had she known, she would have addressed it and possibly pulled me out.
At a public hearing, Sekope shared this experience.
If I'm being honest and brutally honest about my first year at Wesley College, it was grueling at times. And to put it in perspective, everyone would go to bed at night, 8:30, lights out. A chip packet would rattle, or someone would whisper. And the dorm prefect at the time would call out my name. Sekope, get to the middle.
Sekope says he was forced to stand in the middle of the dormitory at night while everyone would sleep. He fought to stay awake because he knew the consequences could include beatings.
But then it happened night after night. The night watchman would come in and he would then ask me, what are you doing? What are you doing now that you're in the middle? You're here parading by yourself. And I couldn't say anything. Sundays was the biggest dread for me coming back.
Away for Kepu! Kepu!
And the man of the moment, Sekope Kepu.
Years on from establishing himself as a sports star, Sekope says the memories still affect him as an adult today and wants other survivors to know they're not alone.
I stand with him. I experienced the same thing. Maybe not to the extent that they did. And I my heart goes out to him. I got young ones now, and to see my three boys, especially, and their vulnerabilities, and seeing the the fear that they have in their faces sometimes. And, you know, I never want to see them, ever go through what I experienced.
The culture of violence has been called the Wesley Way by students for decades, but is now being challenged by survivors as a horrifying tradition.
He would witness abuse not only happening to him but to younger boys.
That's lead counsel Tanya Sharkey reading a summary of survivors' testimonies at a public hearing last year.
Another survivor also confirms that there was a lot of bullying and gang bashings. There was so much physical violence, sexual and mental abuse at the school that he and other students witnessed every day. Juniors were assaulted daily. He witnessed other juniors having their fingers broken from these assaults.
The school accepts what survivors have shared. It also acknowledged that for many, its apology has come decades too late.
Well, we're all very sorry for what happened, and we acknowledge that. And it's really important that we have that in the forefront of our minds as we move forward.
The youngest survivor heard by the inquiry reported being gang-bashed at the school just last year. The school has confirmed that approximately 10 junior students left the school last year after experiencing bullying, violence or abuse. Q&A can also confirm two more students have come forward to the school with allegations of serious physical violence within the past 12 months.
It's on the decline, and hopefully this year, touch wood, there'll be nothing at all. That's the hope. Obviously, we can't control everything. We can't be everywhere. And we can't control, you know, if students are influenced by others to uphold these old ways. But we will continue to make this place, you know, positive as possible.
Q&A received a tip-off about claims of serious concerns found at the school's hostels just last year.
We were told an inspection by the Ministry of Education found senior students sleeping in the same hostel as junior students with no appropriate overnight supervision in place for all the school's hostels. We were also told students had no access to drinking water, no desks for studying, and no phone line to call a staff member for assistance if needed. The school has confirmed the ministry briefly revoked its hostel's licence in December last year.
In a statement, Aero said it was aware of the concerns we raised and said the school had been working with the Ministry of Education to rectify any potential breaches of the education hostels regulations. The Ministry of Education also confirmed this and said after a re-inspection in January, it was now satisfied that the school had met standards to operate 5 of its 6 hostels. The 6th hostel remains shut for renovations. Acting Principal Chris Wood says previously a staff member would be sleeping in a building nearby, but now there is 24/7 overnight supervision in place, with dorm parents staying inside the hostels at night. He says students can access water inside the hostel's kitchen and lounge areas, and that all hostels are now furnished with desks. He said there'd always been a working phone inside the hostels that students could use to contact a staff member.
Given the history of abuse that has been known for decades of the school, how was that acceptable in the first place?
I don't think it was. If I was a parent, I wouldn't be happy if, you know, my son or daughter was unsupervised overnight. And right. I think these current changes are really, really important.
Wood also admitted Year 13 students were temporarily sleeping in the same dorm as Year 9 students while one dorm was being renovated.
So given the allegations of abuse that have predominantly, by the school's admission, been senior students on junior students, and some of those instances of abuse include sexual abuse allegations as well, do you think it was acceptable to have unsupervised senior students sleeping in the same dorm as junior students at night?
I think that was absolutely fine at the time. Our Year 13 students are, you know, amazing bunch of students. They're great leaders, and, you know, that was carefully planned. And like I say, it was only temporary.
Do you accept that that might be a hard pill to swallow for some survivors to hear you say that?
Given the current state of the culture in the school, no. In the past, I can see how survivors would react to that. But given the current state of the culture in the school at the moment, how really positive it is, if yeah, it it's absolutely, it would be fine, yeah, and it's safe.
What assurance can you give parents today that the school is really trying to change the dark history of its past?
In us, we have a new strategic plan, which we've just put out, and part of a significant part of that is the positive culture that we're trying to, you know, cultivate and grow. So we will discuss with parents, you know, some of the issues that we continue to deal with. And I think through that constant dialogue, you know, honesty and transparency, they will be assured that there is a way forward.
About 60 parents have now signed up to an anti-bullying committee, with some parents volunteering to do daily duty monitoring around the school. Sekope Kepu says the community needs to see the school make real change.
A school that we love dearly, and, you know, there are great things that Wesley taught us. But again, you know, there's no place for this abuse and bullying and everything that goes with it.
Indira Stewart with that report. And just so you know, you can see more of Indira's reporting on Wesley College at onenews.co.nz.